Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how we can help the student in better ways. Suppose if the student is working on his laptop and is facing the problem, then we can log on to his machine and we can set right. For example, in our IS department, I instructed the student to work on Keel software, that is, they can write the program in assembly language and they can work on Keel software, but some students face the problem. So I will connect to their computer and I will try to set right the problem. You can see here we have software called as TeamViewer. In TeamViewer, when you click on TeamViewer, TeamViewer is installed on both machines, that is client machine and my machine also. So my machine ID and client has to give his ID and password. I have already connected to the client, my student machine, and you can see here and I found the particular laptop which the student is using. In that laptop, Keel software has not been installed. And the student was facing problem to install the Keel software. So what I did is, I have transferred software from my machine to the remote machine using TeamViewer file control method. And you can see now the software is getting transferred. Software is getting transferred . Once the software is transfer is completed, I will show you how you can install the software on the remote machine. After that, student can work, and if he has got any issue, then we can solve that issue, like we can debug the software errors, etc., by using that one. Now you can see here, software file is getting transferred, and student is also chatting with me through the machine, through the particular software. You can see here. Now you people can see the student is installing Keel software, and you can see I have connected my machine to the remote machine, that is my student machines, and installation is going on. The installation is going on after I have completed the transmission of files from my end to the student machine, because it doesn't have the software. So you can see the Keel installation is going on the remote machine, so that we can help the student in this way also. So installation of the Keel software on the remote machine, that is my student machine, has been completed. He's living in Bombay. So Installation has been completed. You can see here, Keel version 4 has been installed on the remote machine. So I will start the program. Keel Microvision 4 has been installed and it's working now. Hello everyone, now we'll see exactly how this remote connection works. So for connectivity purpose, both machine, that is client and other machine, server machine, we can say server or client, both machine, TeamViewer should be installed. So in my case, TeamViewer is installed on my machine and also it is installed on student machine. And I have helped him to, I have logged into his machine and installed Keel Microvision 4. Now how it works, we will see exactly. So what I will do is, I have already called the student to pass his password and ID. He has passed the password and ID to me. Now I will connect by using TeamViewer. So here, option is partner ID. This is the ID of the particular student. And remote control and file transfer. File transfer is used to transfer the file. Suppose you want to transfer software from your machine to the other machine, you can use it. So connect. So while connecting, it will ask the password. So I have entered the password, log on. Now it is connecting. It has connected to the student machine. Now you can see the Keel Microvision, whatever the software I have installed the software on its machine, and you can see Keel Microvision version 4 has been installed on its machine. I will click on this machine, this icon. So Keel Microvision 4 is getting opened, and you can see the student has written some programs here. If any problem is there, we can debug it. If any error is there, we can help the student through online, so like this. So you can feel like you are working on the normal machine only. For example, like you can save the program, or you can browse this machine, etc. And you can debug the error also. So by this way also, we can help the student. This is very useful. Because most of the students, especially CS and IS students, they can practice at home by using their own laptop. That time they may face some errors. That errors they may not be able to clear it. That time the faculty can log on to their machine and they can help. Other thing is the question comes about the security. What about the security? If the data is so sensitive, then nothing to worry, because TeamViewer works on the principle of SSL protocol, SSL and AES 256 bit encryption standard. Even the TeamViewer parser at their center cannot view the data. It is so secure, nothing to worry. So everyone can make use of this software and they can help the student. Thank you.